के स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डन द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ अवर ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। नाउ आई एम टेकिंग मैक्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री चैप्टर। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द फार्मूला जस्ट नाउ वी हैव लर्न, वी नीड टू सॉल्व वन प्रॉब्लम। ओके, यू सो वी ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट साइन थीटा इज नथिंग बट ऑपोजिट बाई हाइपोटेनियस, कॉस थीटा इज एडजेसेंट बाई हाइपोटेनियस, एंड टैन थीटा इज ऑपोजिट बाई एडजेसेंट। दिस थ्री फार्मूलेस वी ऑलरेडी लर्न। नाउ वी नीड टू अप्लाई दिस फार्मूलेस ऑन दिस प्रॉब्लम। यू कैन सी द क्वेश्चन ऑन बोर्ड। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, I am reading the question. In right angle triangle ABC, 8 cm, 15 cm and 17 cm are the length of AB, BC and CA respectively. Then find out sin A, cos A and tan A. देखिए सवाल क्या दिया कि एक ट्रायंगल है, राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल, ठीक है, और वो ट्रायंगल का नाम दे दिया गया है ABC, ठीक है, जिसमें 8 cm, 15 cm और 17 cm उसके लेंथ है। ए बी बी सी सी ए उसके लेंथ है रेस्पेक्टिवली। हम आपको क्या फाइंड करना है, तीन चीज़ें फाइंड करना है, साइन थीटा, कॉस थीटा एंड टैन थीटा। हियर इंस्टेड ऑफ थीटा वी आर यूजिंग ए, साइन ए, कॉस ए एंड टैन ए। सो लुक एट द बोर्ड स्टूडेंट, आई एम जस्ट ड्राइंग वन ट्राइंगल, यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज एन ट्राइंगल एंड आई एम मार्किंग लाइक ए। यू नो द स्टूडेंट, वी नीड टू डिसाइड विच साइड वी नीड टू मार्क। फर्स्ट यू हैव टू सी द लॉन्गेस्ट साइड, विच इज द लॉन्गेस्ट साइड इन दिस। यस यू आर करेक्ट, द लॉन्गेस्ट साइड हियर इज नथिंग बट A and C. So we need to just mark this as 17 cm. Okay. Now we are taking theta at A. Why at A means, as per the question, we need to take this theta at A. So just opposite this to this side, we have what we have, like 15 cm. Okay. And the remaining is 8 cm. So first we need to mark the length. Okay. If you want, you can remember as per this question. But you know that max is not a subject to modify or mug up. Just we need to understand. Just you need to understand that theta is at A. Here A, B, C. The longest side is 17 cm. And remaining we have like opposite to theta we need to mark like 15 cm. The remaining is AB. This is our triangle drawing part. Okay. Showing you the different. We need to write some theoretical part. I am writing the theoretical part. You can see like, okay, given. What given? Come on student, what given? Yeah, given right angle triangle, okay? Right angle triangle, that is ABC. Right angle triangle ABC, okay? 8 cm, 15 cm and 17 cm are the length of AB, BC and CA respectively. Respectively, okay? Here B is 90 degree and angle A is equals to theta, and we are considering here angle A angle is equals to theta. Okay, after that we need to find what we have to find, sin A. Sin A is nothing but, you know that, length of opposite by length of hypotenuse. Okay, so formula, this is a formula you need to remember. Sin theta is length of opposite by length of hypotenuse, or else in simply we can say like sin, as instead of theta we are using A. Sin A is equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Yes, sin A, what is opposite? Opposite here is 15 and hypotenuse is 17. So sin A is 15 by 17. First answer done. Very simple. You can remember also sin A is equals to length of opposite by length of hypotenuse. Sin A is equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Sin A is 15. Now cos A. Cos A is equals to length of adjacent by length of hypotenuse. Okay. That is, this is a formula. Once again I am writing cos A is equals to short form adjacent by hypotenuse. Okay. Which is equals to, what is adjacent side? Adjacent side is here is 8. Okay. So cos is equals to 8 by, what is hypotenuse? Same as sine, like 17. So you can see I have solved. I am explaining this solution once again. Okay. Here B is 90 degree, A is theta. So sine A is equals to length of opposite by length of hypotenuse. So sine A is equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Sine A is equals to 15. That is 15. Why 15? Opposite side here we have is 15 centimeter. So opposite is 15. Hypotenuse is 17. So sine A done. We found out cos. Cos A is equals to length of adjacent by length of hypotenuse. So cos A is equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. Here adjacent side is 8 cm, okay? We have wrote 8 cm by hypotenuse same like 17 cm.
cos A also done. So we done cos sin A as well as cos A.
Now I am going to tell you about tan A. Okay, student, up to here you need to copy down. Okay, this to this. Only remaining part we have is we need to find tan A. First copy down this. After that I will tell you tan A. Okay. Hope you copied on this. Now I am moving to the tan A. Okay, tan A, you can see board, tan A is equals to, okay student, hope you copied on that sin A and cos A. Now coming to the tan A, tan A is nothing but length of the opposite by length of adjacent. Okay, that is opposite by adjacent. Yeah, we know that tan A is equals to what we have opposite we have 15 centimeter and adjacent we have 8 centimeter. Tan A also done. So we have done sin A, cos A and tan A. That's all for this problem. Very very easy. You need to apply the formulas and you'll get the answer. You can write like, therefore sin A is equals to what we got the answer for sin A, 15/17. Okay, tan, after sin A we have cos A. What we got the answer for cos A, like 8/15. And for tan A what we have got the answer, you can see on the board itself, tan A is 15/8. This is our main answers. Okay, hope you enjoy trigonometric formulas, ratios. Okay, we have done one problem also. Now I am solving second problem. This problem is available in your reader, usually on page number 281, that is exercise 11.1, problem number 2. But in some readers there will be a page plus 1 or 2, like in some reader it might be given on page number 84, like that. But you need to remember this. This is our exercise 11.1, problem number 2. Okay, you can see the question on board. I am reading, just listen with carefully. Okay, the sides of right angle triangle PQR, PQ is equals to 7 centimeter, QR is equals to 25 centimeter and angle Q is equals to 90 degree respectively. Then find tan Q minus tan R. So student, you need to remember one thing. In textbook there is a small error in question. Instead of angle at Q, we need to take angle at P. Okay, I am just writing. Okay, here take angle P is equals to 90 degree instead of angle Q is equals to 90 degree. Okay, this is an error in your textbook, question error. Now I am drawing the triangle. You can just listen. This is an one line. Okay, this is another line. So 90 degree angle where we are taking here as P. Okay, this is P. Next is Q. After Q we have, just we need to join this line. We will get R. So PQ is equals to how much it is given in the question? Come on students. Yes, PQ is equals to 7 centimeter. QR is equals to 25 centimeter. Okay, and angle Q, instead of Q I said we have to take P. Okay, respectively. Then find tan Q minus tan R. One thing, do you observe in the triangle sides? Yes, you are correct. In triangle sides we have only PQ is equals to 7 centimeter and QR is equals to 25 centimeter. We don't have side P and R. For that we need to apply Pythagoras theorem. Okay, from Pythagoras theorem you know that hypotenuse square is equals to adjacent square plus opposite square. So we need to apply this form to this triangle. So what is hypotenuse here? Yes, you can see hypotenuse is nothing but PQ. Okay, PQ square is equals to adjacent, we have adjacent, like hypotenuse is nothing but RQ. Hypotenuse is RQ square is equals to adjacent. Okay, PQ is square plus RP square. This is an Pythagoras theorem I applied. Okay, you know that RQ is given, it is here we have 25 centimeter whole square, which is equals to peak. RQ is equals to 25. I wrote 25 square as it is. Next, PQ is equals to how much we have? 7 centimeter, 7 is here, square is as it is. But we know that we don't have RP square. For RP, we need to keep RP square as it. Now I am continuing this problem. Hope you can see this part of the board. So here we need to find RP. RP square is equals to, like just RP square goes there and 7 here. So we have 25 square minus 7 square we got. How we got? I am just explaining once again. You can see this part. Here we have RP square. Okay,
RP square is same and 25 square also here same. What we are doing, just we are transferring here R 7 square plus 7 goes back to minus 7 square. So I am explaining how this step comes. So now RP square is equals to 25, 25 the we need to, that is 625 minus 77 the 49. So 625 minus 49 we have 576. Okay. RP square is equals to 576. RP is equals to under root of 576. 576 is the root of 24. So we got RP is equals to 24 centimeter. Okay. Now we find the RP. Then next, what step we need to do? Just we need to find tan Q and tan R. After finding these two values, just we need to subtract these two values. Okay. First copy down this part. After that, I will continue. Okay. Copy down. You can see the problem here, solution here. Everything you can see and you can copy down. Now next, first we need to know the formula for tan theta. Okay. What is tan theta? Come on student, it is nothing but opposite by adjacent. Okay. This is a formula for tan theta. What we need to find? First we need to find tan Q. If we are considering tan Q, means tan theta formula is opposite by adjacent. Okay. First we need to find tan Q. If we need to find tan Q, we need to consider this as theta. So we have opposite side this, adjacent side this. This is for tan Q, and for tan R we need to suppose this is an theta. So opposite side will be this and adjacent is this. Make sure that there is a change in only opposite and adjacent side. Hypotenuse side is same, this side. Okay. Just I am marking P Q R. Okay. Here also P Q R. So first I am finding, you can see this part. Okay. Tan Q. Look at the board, all of you. Tan Q is equals to, yes, opposite by adjacent. What is opposite here? This side. So what is the value of opposite side? 24. So 24 by adjacent. Adjacent value is 7 cm. Tan Q done. Next, tan R. Tan, we need to find tan Q, tan R. Tan R is nothing but same. This is an theta. This is an opposite side. So opposite side we have 7 by. What is adjacent here? RP, here 24. So tan R is 24. So we found out tan Q and tan R. These two things we already done. Now what the question is? Question is this. We need to finally find tan Q minus tan R. So look at the board, student. Tan Q minus tan R, which is equals to 24 by 7 minus 7 by 24. Just we need to cross multiply. This is 24 square, this is 7 square by 24 into 7. How this happens, I will show you. Look at here, this 24 the, after this 7 the, after that this fourth fraction both into 7 into 24. Copy down till here, just I am continuing. Last we have two steps with us. Okay student, so 24 the, once again I am writing tan Q minus tan R, which is equals to 24 the, just now we did 576 minus 49 by, that is 24 7 is, it is 168. So now which is equal to 576 minus 49, just we are doing here 576 minus 49, 16 out of 9 what we left, like 7, 6 out of 4, 2, 527. This is 527 by 168. We got answer. This is our answer. Exercise 11.1, problem number 3. Okay, you can see on the board question. I am reading this question. Look at the board. In right angle triangle ABC. Okay, in right angle triangle ABC with right angle at B. Right angle at B, in which A is equals to 24 units, B is equals to 25 units, angle BAC is equals to theta. Then find cos theta and tan theta. One more thing here we need to write, like a is equals to, you can, okay. Now I am taking the solution. Look at here, this is our triangle ABC. Theta is here as the angle BAC is equals to theta. Okay, A is equals to 24 units. Here you can say, okay, now I am drawing the triangle here. Look at here, triangle, right angle triangle, okay, ABC. So right angle at B. So we are just putting this at right angle at B. So
in which a is equals to 24 units. How to decide a is equals to 24 units and b is equals to 25 units? Means here you can see like BC is nothing but 24 units and AC is nothing but 25 units. You can put it this like. Now, and angle BAC is equals to theta. Find cos theta and tan theta. So here we need to first, we have two sides with us. B and C is 24 units, A and C is 25 units. We don't have A and B side. So for that we need to apply Pythagoras theorem, okay? From Pythagoras theorem, okay? It is Pythagoras theorem says hypotenuse square is equals to adjacent square plus opposite square. So you can see here hypotenuse square is nothing but we have 25 square, adjacent square with respect to theta. What is here? Hypotenuse is 25, okay? And with respect to theta, opposite side will be BC. So adjacent side will be AB. So adjacent is nothing but here AB square plus opposite side is 24 square. Just I am keeping 25 as it is. Just I am taking this plus 24, it's become minus 24 square, which is equals to AB. This is an as it is step. Just we are taking this plus 25 to left hand side, it's become minus 24. So finally, what is AB square? AB square is equals to here 24 square. What is 24 square? Yes, 24 square is 576 and 25 square is 625. So 625 minus 576. How it's come? 25 square is 625, 24 square is 576. So AB square this. Now AB square is equals to, just we need to minus the 625 minus 576. What we got? Yes, you are correct. We will get 49. We will cross check here. Look at the board. 576. 5 minus 6, it is not happened. So it's become 15. 15 minus 6, we have 9. Okay. After that, this 62 becomes 61. So 61 minus like 57, what we have? 4. Simple, 49. So AB is equals to under root of 49. How this under root comes? Just this square goes to that place. So it's become under root. So AB is equals to 7 units. So just I am writing 7 here. So now with respect to, look at the board, all of you, with respect to theta here, okay, what is here hypotenuse side? Hypotenuse is nothing but here AC, which is equals to 25 centimeter. What is adjacent side here? Adjacent is nothing but AB, okay, which is equals to 7. Here we need to write units. And what is opposite sides? Opposite is nothing but BC, which is equals to 24. Just I am summarizing this problem. We got question. We need to just find cos theta and tan theta. So it is given as ABC is right angle triangle at B, in which AB is equals to 24 centimeter, BC is equals to, that is B is equals to 25 units. Just I am drawing one right angle triangle. You can see here. Triangle ABC. So BC already given as 24 units, AC given as 25 units. We need to find AB. To find AB, we are just applying Pythagoras theorem. After applying the Pythagoras theorem, we got AB as 7 unit. Once we got the AB as 7 units, just we have decided which side is which. So just we are, with respect to theta, hypotenuse is AC, which is equal to 25 units. Adjacent is AB, which is equal to 7 units. Opposite is BC, which is equal to 24 units. Just copy down this problem till here. Pause your video for few seconds and copy down. This is question, this is solution. After that, we will continue this, okay? Okay, student, first we need to find the cos theta. Hope I am just finding here cos theta and tan theta separately. Yeah, cos theta is nothing but adjacent by hypotenuse, as you know, adjacent very, what is adjacent here? 7, okay, and hypotenuse is 25. Cos theta, done, okay. Tan theta, we know tan theta, yes, come on student, what is the formula of tan theta, tell me. Yes, you are correct, tan theta is opposite by adjacent, okay, tan theta is equals to, like, what is opposite here? 24, and adjacent is 7, done, problem is done. Cos theta is equal to 7 by 25, tan theta is equal to 24 by 7. If you want, you can just write one step here to elongate your problem. Therefore, cos theta is equal to 7 by 25 and tan theta is equal to 24 by 7. That's all. Done.